At this point, you might realize that you've been defining a particular function every time you wanted to animate your program, the draw function. To remind you, here's our animated car program again. It has this variable named x that starts off at 11, and then inside the draw function, it draws the car at that variable x, and then it adds 3 to that variable x each time. And that results in a car that's moving 3 pixels across the screen continuously. So that's how this works. But now that you've learned how to make your own functions, you might be wondering, what about this draw function? Why is it always named draw? Is it a custom function? And those are very good questions. You see, in the Processing.js library, the draw function is one of a few predefined functions that give our programs more control over what's happening with the canvas. A predefined function is one that has already been defined by the Processing.js library, but it usually starts off as an empty definition. For example, in the Processing.js library, there's code that looks like this. Our draw equals function, and then it's just empty, completely empty. Now, we load the Processing.js library into every program here on Khan Academy, so you never see this code. But trust me, it exists. Now I'll comment that code out, since Processing.js already does it for us. Now, when you redefine draw in your own program, this new definition overrides the old empty definition. And now the draw function actually does exciting things, like drawing a car. Now the question is, why does the draw function get called over and over? Well, there's also code in the Processing.js library that sets a browser timer and recalls the draw function repeatedly, over and over and over. We have to name the function draw because that's the name of the function that Processing.js is calling repeatedly. If we rename this, like let's say we rename it to draw car, and first we get an undefined error. So we could say var draw car. So now you can see if we rename this to draw car, we don't see any animation anymore. And that's because this function isn't being called repeatedly anymore because it's not named draw. So we have to put the code that we want to be repeatedly called inside a function spelled draw. Exactly. So I'll just do it again and I'll just call draw car from here. Aha, we've got it back. All right. So it needs to be called draw. And this also means that you shouldn't name your own custom functions draw unless you want them to be treated specially and called over and over. And also remember, you can't have multiple functions named draw. Only the last definition will count. So if we had a rect inside here. So now we can see that our car isn't being drawn anymore and only the rect is being drawn instead, because only the last definition counts. So let's get rid of that one. Now the draw function is not the only predefined function that has this special behavior. There are also a bunch of functions for responding to mouse interactions and key presses. Let's say we want to have a program that draws a colored ellipse wherever the user moves the mouse. So we could do that with a function like this. I'm going to say mouse x, mouse y, and then ellipse, mouse x, mouse y, 10, 10. That's good. All right. Oh, beautiful. Now, this function is being called over and over, even when the user isn't moving the mouse, like right now. And this program, it works. It does what we want it to do. It's painting these nice ellipses all over the screen. But as it turns out, there's a better way to do the same thing that's more efficient. So we can change the draw function to mouseMoved. And let's see, and it still works. You see, our environment checks programs to see if they've defined a mouseMoved function, and if so, it calls that function whenever the user moves the mouse. But it won't be called if the user isn't moving the mouse. So before, we were calling the code in the draw function when we didn't need to over and over. And now we're only calling this code in mouseMoved when the mouse X or mouse Y have actually changed. So our program is more efficient, and that's a good thing. Generally, if you only want to change your program output when the user moves the mouse, then it's better to have that code inside the mouseMoved function. And there are a bunch more predefined functions like that, which you can see more examples of in the documentation, like mousePressed, mouseReleased, keyPressed, and more. So remember, if you want to use a special predefined function, like mouseMoved or draw, spell it correctly and use it correctly. If you don't, then make sure you give your own custom functions a new, unique name.